Please watch it again. welcome this morning to the Rathington Community Center. We've got the Bulldogs and the Mariners playing their championship game this evening. Let the Mariners clear it out there. We've got number four, McIntyre, for the Bulldogs with the puck here. He'll move behind his net. Number 8, Lucas with the puck, the team captain for the Mariners. He'll move out in front. He'll move it back to the defenseman. This is number 23. He'll fire a shot up and wide of the net. Mariners, the home team for this game. They're in white. Bulldogs in the black and yellow. Sorry, Mariners in yellow, not white. For the Mariners on the puck, he'll clear it out. Lucas on the puck now. He'll move it out to center, have the puck skip away from him, and it's cleared back in by the Bulldogs. Good play there by the Mariners defenders. He'll move it up there. This is Dion back on the puck now. He'll move in over the wing, dump it into the corner there. Bulldogs on the puck first there, and they'll move it up. This is the U11-A level finals. Bulldogs and Mariners. Antigonish Bulldogs and Yarmouth Mariners on the finals right now. Meyer has the puck skip away from him, and Akers plays it to the corner for the Mariners. Kept in there at the line there by the Bulldogs defender. Cleared up, that will be offside at the line. Not quite able to hold the line there by number 8 for the Bulldogs. Chisholm on the puck here for the Bulldogs. He'll move it up. Not quite over the red line as the Mariners will hold their end of the ice. He'll attempt again. This time he will get it over the red line. Moved ahead there by the Mariners defender. Back in, and once again Chisholm on the puck. He'll go behind his own net with this one. Move it up the wing. It's kept in there again by the Mariners defender. I apologize for the lack of player names occasionally. I don't exactly know these teams that well, and trying to work the camera and everything, trying to figure out player names is not the easiest. That's a shot there by Akers, and a big save by the Bulldogs goaltender. Back behind the net, Chisholm on the puck. He'll try to get to it there first. He'll chip it out. And McKenzie steals it away back at center. He's in over the line. He'll try to cut back, but he's stopped there by number 4 of the Bulldogs. That was McIntyre. Stewart on the puck. He'll try to throw it in towards the net, but it's blocked there by the Hughes. Backhand shot in there. I believe that was McIntyre on the shot. It's cleared out there by Akers. And the video cut it. Apologies for that video cut out there for a second. Loose wire. Hughes will move it back to his defenseman partner. That was McIntyre over. It's Dion with the block at the blue line. He'll move in 2-on-1 right now. He'll take a shot. Ooh, trickles just by, but kept out there by McIntyre. Pulling that one off the goal line. Good play by the young defenseman. McIntyre on it again here. Hughes with it at the red line for the Bulldogs. He'll dump it into the corner. Mariners clear it out. It's Dion on the puck again at the blue line. He will get it out. Hopkins moves it back in for the Bulldogs, but it's turned over there. Number 23, that's D's. Apologies for the pronunciation of some of these names. I'm not 100% sure on the pronunciation on everything. Bulldogs defender fans on clearing it out, but he does get it out in the second attempt. Dion, who I'm not sure if he's left the ice yet this game. He is on the puck, and he'll dump it back in. Hughes on it now for the Bulldogs. Moved up by the Bulldogs. They're in over the line. This is Warkop. Throws it in on goal, just off the post, side of the net there. Thrown out in front. This is Wallace in pursuit of the puck there, kept in by Doyle. Moved up to center, number 18, Captain Lucas on the puck there for the Mariners, and he will gain the red line, chip it forward. And the Bulldogs defender on it now. Warkop loses his own teammates' skates, but Hopkins on the puck now, coming in over the wing. He'll fire a shot just wide of the goal. Takes a bounce off the stanchion, comes right out in front, but it's able to be cleared there by number 8 of the Mariners. Wallace on the puck, she'll make a move around one defender, but stopped by Myers there at the line. That is just offside. That was Orcop, who couldn't quite get back onside on that play there. Mariners win the draw. Akers wins the draw there. He'll move it up over to Wallace at center. In over the line. Take a shot in on goal. The drop blocked by the McDaniels. Cameron in pursuit now, but it's chopped away there by the Mariners assistant captain. Cameron back on it now. He'll dump it in behind the Mariners goal. Quickly on it is Bulldogs forward. Cameron keeps it in that line there. Thrown on goal, but it's knocked down by the Mariners defender. Moving ahead with it now, that was Nickerson with the drift dump in. McDaniel on it now for the Bulldogs. In behind his own goal, he'll take a look. Try to chop it out, but it's kept in by the Mariners defender. This is Akers on it now. He'll move out in front, take the shot. And the Bulldogs goaltender is able to cover it up. Starting in goal for the Bulldogs, that is Key McInnes in net. And for the Mariners, it's Owen Boudreau starting for the Mariners in goal right now. Neither have really been tested. The Mariners with two shots. The Bulldogs still yet to get a shot on goal. A couple chances, but nothing that's hit the goal. They've hit the side of the net, and they've had two or three of them go wide, but here they come now. Number 14 in on the wing. He'll take a shot, and a blocker save. Might have caught the paddle there for Boudreau. A good save by the young netminder. Not a good contact at the blue line. No call by the referees. Good call there. Got Murphy with the puck now. He'll dump it into the corner. McIntyre in pursuit there, but the Mariners forward will get to it first. That was McKenzie on the puck there. Bulldogs out 3-on-2 here, just onside. It's McInnes on the puck at the moment there. Boat battle Nickerson with the puck and throw it in on goal, but it's blocked. Shot by Boudreau there on Boudreau, but it's blocked and dribbled wide. From an odd angle to shot by the Bulldogs, will get blocked, and we got Boudreau on the puck now. Nickerson draped all over him, will lose the puck. It's kept in at the line there by Hughes. No, it's not, because he'll chop it out. Stewart able to get it out the center. McIntyre pursuing the puck, he'll lose it there, but Boudreau's back on it. He'll throw a goal there, and a nice save by Boudreau steering it to the corner. Boyle on the puck, he'll clear it out to the Mariners' end, but it's kept in by Murphy and dumped back in by the... Ooh, it's going to be called as an icing on that one, as the Bulldogs didn't quite get center. Myers and Lucas on this faceoff right now. Myers will win the draw there for the Bulldogs. Quick shot on goal. Saved by the Bulldogs goaltender. It will skip by the defender. Myers in pursuit, but he's unable to get to it. Boyle picks it up at the red line. He moves in over the line. He'll lose it there to Lucas. Lucas will chip it ahead for Dion. Back to Lucas. He's got Dion going towards the net. McDonald on the puck now for the Bulldogs. He'll move it ahead. Trying to chip it out. Lucas doing a good job to just shield him off the puck. Boyle on it now. He'll move it out to center. Gets out over the blue line, but can't quite. Dion on it now for the Mariners as he moves in. Gets it to the corner. Boyle will get to it first, and Dion just falls over, taking Boyle with him. McDonald on it. He'll chip it ahead. This is Myers to the Bulldogs. He will chip it ahead, unable to get to it, unfortunately, and the Mariners will turn around as Lucas, team captain, in on the move. But a shot, big save by the Bulldogs goaltender. Coming up big when his team needs it. And the Bulldogs out 2-on-3 right now. They'll just get it over the line. The rest of their line mates on the line change there. Chisholm has it go by him. Daniel in pursuit of the puck. Chip it ahead. Chisholm takes it. Turns it over at the faceoff dot. Throws it in front of the net. Nobody home for that. It's kept in there by number 17, Purdy. Throws it in behind the goal. Chipped off the boards and around a defender. Able to move it out in front. That was Nicholson in pursuit of the puck now out the blue line. He'll chip it back in. Chisholm on the puck now. He's got McDaniel to his right, and he will pass it over that way. Fans on the clearing attempt, but it does get out. And we've got a penalty coming up here to number 38. That is Aker. He'll head to the box there for tripping on the play as he took the feet out from underneath, trying to see a jersey number on that. I believe that was that was tripped up in neutral zone. It's the Bulldogs into the power play now. Face up win there by the Mariners, but can't quite get it out. McHattie on the puck and along the boards. Throws it out in front, but it's intercepted. Bulldogs just unable to keep it in. As it's cleared back in, Murphy on the puck now for the Mariners, and he will dump it down the length of the ice. McIntyre going in behind his own net there to pick it up. We'll move it up the boards. Quick little chip there to McIntyre, and he will lose it, but he'll pick it back up. Back up the ice to McIntyre. Throw it in on goal, and a big save by Boudreau, and he'll hold on. No rebound on that play. Great save by the young netminder. And thank you for tuning in from the Rathausen Community Center. This is the Antigonish Bulldogs and Yarmouth Mariners. U11-A level. Their league final right now. McHattie on the faceoff there. He'll win it, but Dion turns it over. Pursuit in front of the net there, and it is cleared away. McIntyre blocks the clearing attempt there. He'll go in behind the net. Moving over, he's got two teammates in front of the net there. He'll move it back to the point there for McIntyre. Clear it back. That's McHattie on the puck there now. Good stick check there. McHattie knocks it down. McIntyre unable to keep it in. He'll just clear it right back into the zone. That'll go right onto the stick of number 35 for the Mariners. Whoa! Big crash in behind the net there. He'll get up. He'll be able to skate that one off. He'll work his way to the bench there. Collision with the end boards there. That was Hughes. A little bit of pain there. He's unable to get to the bench as the Mariners stole the puck. He doesn't have his stick. He will work his way to the bench there now. Got a penalty coming up there to the Bulldogs. A little bit of a hook there. I believe that will be McIntyre. Maybe that's McHattie going to the bench. It's McIntyre going to the penalty box there. He'll take two for hooking on the play. One of those penalties as a coach, you can't quite be too upset on that one. Stop the scoring chance there, as it was a 2-on-1 coming in for the Mariners. So penalty that's not may have negated a goal. So Bulldogs out there on a rush here. We've got Sill coming down the wing, unable to get it. Sorry, that was Boyle down the wing there, losing it there in a puck battle. Wallace clears it out center. McDonald will just dump it right back into the Mariners' end. Shots on goal, still the Mariners with three, Bulldogs with only two. Mariners will now go to the power play as their penalty expires, and they will score. This is Wallace with the goal as it's thrown out in front by Lucas. Wallace just battles in front of the net until he's able to squeeze it by the Mariners' goaltender. Sorry, the Bulldogs' goaltender. It's a 1-0 lead there on the goal by Wallace. Take a 1-0 lead here on their fourth shot of the game as it's just thrown out in front of the net by Lucas, and Wallace is able to shovel the puck home. Clear it out the center. McDaniel in pursuit. They'll move it along the board. Boyle attempting to get to that one, but is unable to. Move ahead. McKenzie in pursuit. McKenzie going to battle in the corner there. Chisholm moves it ahead. Cleared out there. Icing as Potty gets to it. Stewart clears it out. McKenzie on the puck now. McKenzie over the red and over the blue line. He'll move in. One on two. Takes the shot and a nice save in the bread basket by the Antigonish Bulldogs goaltender. Shot, a nice block there by the Bulldogs defender. Mariners on it in the neutral zone. Move it ahead. This is Wallace, our goal scorer, on the puck now. We get bumped off the puck by Cameron, who moves it ahead. I believe this is Boyle with it coming through the neutral zone now. A little move at the blue line. Akers steals the puck. Hughes on it now, moving along the half boards. Clears it at the corner where Aker can't quite get to it in time. Purdy will move it along the boards. Wallace in pursuit of it there. Four Bulldogs on her. Hughes will just dump it in off the linesman, who then gets bumped into by Nickerson and falls down. Purdy will clear it out the center. Turned over there, and this is Nickerson. He's being pursued there by... Oh, and we're going to have a penalty there as Hughes takes down Nickerson. It'll be either a trip or a hook on that one. Akers on the puck now still for the Mariners as a delayed penalty is on its way. And we have roughing is the penalty on that one. For Hughes taking down Nickerson along the boards there. So the Mariners will head to their second power play. Their first power play got interrupted by a penalty of their own as they went to play 4-on-4. That penalty expired and the Mariners immediately scored to make it 1-0 on the goal by Wallace. Mariners win the draw. It's Lucas on the draw with that win, and it's cleared the length of the ice. Mariners defender will pick it up behind the net and turn back the other way. He's got Lucas in front of him, and Lucas will move out to center. Try to move it ahead. Knocks off. So after one period, as you can hear over the PA, the Bulldogs down one. The Mariners with the goal by Wallace. 1-0. Shots on goal after your first period. The Yarmouth Mariners at 5, Antigonish Bulldogs with just 2. Minute 36 on the penalty. That was charge to... Mason Hughes, who had the roughing penalty with 24 seconds left in the period. He'll have another minute 36 to serve to start this second period. Bulldogs and the Mariners make their way back onto the ice here for the second period. Clock winding down, the final 5 seconds of this short intermission between periods here. And unlike the first game, I will remember that to the second period on the clock. There we go. And Lucas on the draw there for the Mariners. As they continue their power play, it's won there by McHatty, who wins it to the defenseman Boyle, who will clear it down the length of the ice. And we'll restart the period as the clock was not set yet. We had this during the start of the third period of our morning game, where in the U11-B division, the Cole Harbour Wings came back from being down in the first period 3-0. They came back and won that one in overtime, 5-4, over the Chester Ravens. So congratulations to the U11-B Cole Harbour Wings, who take home the provincial championship at that age level. Here this morning, we've got the Yarmouth Mariners Antigonish Bulldogs in the middle of their second period there, 1-0 for the Mariners. Which will just be starting this period as we've got to reset the clock there. A little bit of technical difficulties at the moment. And people call the referee over there as they try to figure out what's going on with the clock there. Bulldogs players will head back to their bench, get a couple more instructions there by their coach. Power play, minute 36 left for the Mariners. They've got Lucas and Murphy up front, along with number 20, that's McKenzie, on the left side. Still working on the clock here on the back end. Number 23 and number 19, that is Huskelson and D's on the back end. Try a clock reset and see if this works at all down there by the looks of it there. We do occasionally have trouble here at the Credit Union Community Center inside the Rathison Community Center. That is quite a mouthful. They really need to shorten down that name. That's why we went with just calling it the Wreck. Okay, so the buzzer works. That's nice and loud. Goal in the first period again was scored by Lucas. Sorry, assisted by Lucas. Let's throw it out in front. It's Kingston Lucas, team captain for the Yarmouth County Mariners. Threw it out in front of the net, and Wallace was able to tuck it home past Key McInnes. Both goaltenders have been solid so far to start this game, despite the one goal scored against. Now to 14:53. So, okay, they do have it set going there. They're just giving it a test there. Set to 15 minutes at the moment. Just need to get the penalty fixed. There we go. Minute 36 back on there after the penalty. It's charged to Mason Hughes, his roughing penalty late in the period. Get all their other stats entered in there as they get the Mariners goal back on there, and they slowly count up the shots here, get it back to 5-2. Shots on goal for the Mariners as the bench and the fans erupt as they try to get the energy back going here as we have that short delay. And it looks like we're ready to rock and roll for the second period. Lucas on the draw here against McHattie for the Bulldogs. Lucas has been great in that first period on the draw as McHattie will win that one. It's cleared ahead for Murphy just over his stick. Lucas on the puck now for the Mariners. Move in over the line and take a shot right off the mask there of the Bulldogs defender, and he'll clear it out to center. Move back in, it'll be just onside. So McKenzie will clear it in over the zone. McDonald loses it there to Lucas, who's able to block the clearing attempt. He'll move in, move around a couple of defenders, take a shot, and he will pick the top corner. What a goal by team captain Lucas as he will add to his one assist from earlier and put on a power play goal. Makes a move around two defenders and rips the shot high over the Bulldogs defenders, the goaltender's blocker, to make this game 2-0. That'll make the Mariners 2-0, 2-for-2 on the power play. They were able to score in the first on the power play, and Lucas will get his second point of the game, second power play point of the game as well, making it 2-0 Mariners. McHattie on the draw as he won the faceoff there against Baker. Hopkins over the line there. He'll try to make up quickly for his, that's a via goal by the Bulldogs. Rebound off Luke off the shot. Trying to see a name or a number of the goal scorer. It is Boudreaux, who will score against Boudreaux. He's able to find the rebound to the right of Boudreaux. I'm starting to confuse myself now with so many Boudreaux's, but Boudreaux will make it 2-1 for the Bulldogs. Quick response by the Bulldogs here to get back in this one. Myers on the draw now against Aker. One ahead by Aker, right to Chisholm of the Bulldogs. Chipped back, right back to Chisholm. Seems to have more touches of the puck than the referees at this rate. It's dumped in and picked up at the hash marks there, and once again, back to Chisholm. He'll dump it in again. Potty on the puck there behind his own goal. Move it on the boards, kept in. Bulldogs on it along the half boards. Protection there, I believe that's Myers on the puck. Nickerson makes a move with the line. Still on it. Throws it in on goal. What a save there by the Bulldogs goaltender. And Ron throws a backhand just wide of the goal. That will get cleared and just kept in by Dees. Aker on the puck there for the Mariners. He'll just dump into the corner. Moved up the wing there by McIntyre. He will move over the line. He's got Myers to his right. Keeps on bowling his way towards the corner, using a good job to protect the puck. But a second player from Mariners is able to pick up the puck there. That was Aker on the puck. Nickerson loses it, but Aker picks it back up, and he'll lose it. Meyer doing a good job with his feet there to move the puck around and cover it up by Boudreaux as it bounces in on goal. U11-A level provincial final, Antigonish Bulldogs, Yarmouth Mariners. The Mariners up 2-1 over the Bulldogs with 12:40 left in the second period. Turned over there, we have Basil over the blue line. Just get it into the corner, Dion on it. Dion will shrug him off and clear it out. Lucas on the puck there, team captain. Goal and assist already in this one, and just rip it over the crossbar. Just missing that one, looking for his second of the game. Cameron in pursuit now. He won't quite get to it as the Mariners defender gets to it first. He'll chip it out. It's 2-on-1 right now. Lucas on it. Dion on it with Lucas. Boyle and Cameron will decide who's going to take the puck. That will be just offside as Cameron had to make the move at the line there. Face-off on the far side of the ice there. Boudreau, Hopkins, and McHattie on the ice there for the Bulldogs up front. Murphy taking the draw for the Mariners. He'll win the draw, but Boyle jumps it and is able to grab the puck. Not quite able to get in deep, however. Bulldogs defender has a look and finds Boudreau along the far side, the Bulldogs goal scorer. McHattie unable to pick up that pass by Boudreau. He'll throw it out in front and just missing a scoring opportunity there was the Bulldogs forward Hopkins on that one. Clear it out. McDaniel on it now for the Bulldogs. He'll just dump it right back into the Mariners' end. Mariners out sending McHattie. Blocks that shot attempt or pass attempt there. And he'll move his way forward with the puck. He'll overskate the puck. He's turned over there. This is Murphy for the Mariners. Making a move on Boudreau there to then just dump it in. McDaniel chips it ahead to Boudreau and just chip it by the Mariners defenders. Cleared back ahead to Stewart of the Mariners. McKenzie on it at center. Has it just jumped by him? And McDaniel will clear it back out to center. McDaniel and Chisholm for the Bulldogs have had a lot of minutes so far early in this game. I don't know if I've said the name of another defender for the Bulldogs in this game. Every time I turn around, those two are on the ice. Good, responsible defenders for the Bulldogs so far in this game. Moved out in front there, and we've got Stewart on it, and he will just barely squeeze it by. The Mariners will take a 3-1 lead. Puck just bounced out in front there for number four of the Mariners, and he's able to bury that just. Stewart with that one. 3-1 Mariners. 10-17. We've got Myers and Akers on the draw there after the Mariners goal to make it 3-1. Face off one to Nickerson. Moves it ahead to Hughes. Hughes will attempt to clear it out of the zone. Boyle will try to help him, but Aker able to keep the puck. And Aker will upend Boyle into the boards and he'll go off either hooking or tripping. The Bulldogs, however, will try to get something going here before the delayed penalty is called. Aker, that will go as a hooking penalty as he took down the Bulldogs. Boyle along the boards. 9-4 shots on goal right now for the Mariners. Low shooting affair compared to our first game this morning where shots, I believe, 32-27 were final shots. Both goaltenders played really good considering a 5-4 score. Both goalies making huge saves there. Boudreau on the puck there for the Bulldogs. As the Bulldogs start their power play, bounces in on goal and not able to get through. But Cameron on it now and he will pop the power play marker. Bulldogs draw it back within one. 3-2 Mariners. Throw the puck on goal and you see what happens. That was Hopkins on the goal, actually, not Cameron. My apologies. Hopkins with the power play marker as he's able to find the puck to the left of the Mariners goaltender and is able to squeeze it home. Just shows all you have to do is just throw the puck on the goal and see what happens. That's all the Bulldogs did. They threw it towards the goal and just kept bouncing forward. That puck had eyes for where it wanted to go. And Hopkins was able to put it right where it wanted. Hopkins on it again now as he'll send it off the side of the goal. Moved around, thrown out in front. Boudreau unable to pick up that pass. Just skipped off his stick there. That was good back check there by Boudreau as he's able to pick up the puck. That will go for icing as it's fired down the length of the ice. Marks a loop, come away with it. They'll move in, take the shot. Good save there by the Bulldogs defender, goaltender. Kept in twice by the Mariners defenders. Lucas back on it now as he's been all over the ice tonight. This morning, I guess. Dion on it now as it bounces away from the Bulldogs goaltender. Off the boards and not quite out there for the Bulldogs. Just knocked back down. Kelsey just keeps going forward with it. Still on it. Throws it on goal. Good blocker save there by Boudreau. Pick on it now for the Mariners. Move it ahead. Gets stopped. Lucas on it now. There's just skips by, but she's off. Just got stopped at the line there by Hopkins just enough. And Lucas couldn't get back onside as the puck bounced in behind him. And this is the U11-A division provincial final between the Antigonish Bulldogs and Yarmouth Mariners with just about 8 minutes left in the second period. The Mariners have a 3-2 lead. McKenzie's able to grab the puck there for the Mariners. Stewart throws it in the goal. Murphy gets stopped by Chisholm. Good defensive play there by Chisholm to stop the scoring attempt. Mariners throw it to the center of the ice there for Stewart. Unable to pick it up. McDaniel in the corner with it. We will chip it out to the blue line where it's just kept onside. Thrown on goal. Ever stopped by Rorcott. But he's unable to get to that puck there. Kenzie on the puck there, I believe, now. Throws it just wide of the goal. Kept in by Stewart. He'll throw it behind the net there for Murphy. Murphy throws it out in front. Blocked by McDaniel. Unable to clear, however. Bounces out to Stewart in the slot. This will now get cleared out there. Huskelson will chip it back out. 3-on-2 for the Mariners coming in. They'll lose it there. Chisholm misplays, miscommunication with his teammates. And Stewart with a good blocker save there. However, by the Mariners, by the Bulldogs goaltender. Thrown into the center of the ice there. Knocked away from McKenzie there. Hickelson loses it as Boyle blocks a shot. He comes in. Good defensive play there by both Mariners defenders. Able to close him off and keep him from setting anything up down there. Murphy outskates that puck there. Bulldogs defender will ring it around the boards there. Moved ahead by Hopkins. Hopkins on the puck. McHattie coming into the zone along the hash marks. Turns back and throws it to the center of the ice. Hopkins chips it just wide and Boudreau unable to reach for that puck. Rugby scrum in the corner there for the puck, and McHattie has it out in front, unable to get a shot attempt though. Mariners coming out 3-on-2 over the line there into the hash marks. Cut off nicely by the Bulldogs defender there to keep them wide, and Hopkins will clear it to the blue line, not out. Potty keeps it in. Hopkins on it in the corner again. McHattie over there to help him out. Kept in by Potty, however. Still kept in by Potty. Great job there to recover to keep that in on the second attempt. Kaker on the puck for the Mariners. And McHattie unable to keep it in that time, however. Overskating the puck, there's the Bulldogs forward there, and Hughes has it chipped by him. That will not be icing there. A couple players jousting there, the blue line collision, but no call by the referee. Cameron out, Potty in front of him, the Mariners defender. Shot on goal just wide of the net. And behind the net, a little puck battle there, and the Mariners will come away with it. Moved ahead to Wallace, scored our opening goal of the game here on the power play, assisted by Lucas. Speak for the devil, there's Lucas on the puck there now. Dion will take it over the line. Makes a couple moves around a couple players, so tried to throw it in on goal and is blocked there by the Bulldogs defender. Dion on it now. Cameron coming out for the Bulldogs. And we'll throw it down the length of the ice. That will be icing. Just a few strides shy of the red line. But that will allow the line change for the tired Bulldogs defenders. They were stuck on that ice there for a minute or so. McDonald, Warcott, Myers, and the two Boyles will step on the ice for the Bulldogs after the icing. Meyer will lose the draw. Dion trying to throw a quick shot on goal after the faceoff win by Lucas, but it's blocked. And Meyer will dump it the length of the ice. That will have just enough for icing. And we'll turn around and reset and try faceoff to the left of goaltender Key McInnes. Hope I'm pronouncing that right. Didn't have time before this game with a quick turnaround from the prior game to learn any pronunciations of player names. McDonald rings around the board there, and Boyle on it now. Boyle coming down the left wing. Tries to move it ahead for Meyer, but it's snuffed by the Mariner defenders. Boyle would dump it back in. The Mariners in 3-on-1. Lucas makes a move there. Throws in front. Dion just unable to get a stick on it. Boyle throws it in the middle of the ice. It's intercepted there. Lucas on it now. Throw it in on goal. Good pad save. Dion throws it to the corner there. And it's not quite cleared out. Good job by Lucas to stop that one with hash marks on the clearing attempt. He'll throw it out in front. Bounce off a stick up over top of the net. Dion on it now. Lucas with it once again. He'll throw it on goal. Blocker save, and oh, it's just knocked off the line by Warcop. Great job by Warcop there to stop a goal that was just bouncing inside the post, and he's able to swat it away from the goal and throw it to the corner. Great job by Warcop after the puck was blocker saved by Bulldogs goaltender. Patty in the corner, he'll try to throw it out in front, but it bounces off a couple skates and it's out to center now. Mariners, McKenzie on it in the corner, Stewart and Murphy in front of the net. He'll throw it there, Stewart picks up the pass, unable to get a shot off. He's still on the puck, however, he finally shoots. And a nice save and a second nice save on Murphy. Great job by D. McInnes making a couple good saves there. Shots now 14-6 for the Mariners. Only hold a 3-2 lead, however, as Key McInnes has done everything he can inside that net to stop the Mariners. A shot just over top of the net there. Stewart picks it up in the corner. He'll throw it there to Murphy. Murphy's got McKenzie in front of the net, but he's unable to get it there. This is Boudreau for the Bulldogs. He'll go over the blue line to get it out. Hughes on it now. Murphy with a good stick check there to knock it away from him as McKenzie step in over the line, take the shot. Pad save by Key McInnes. Hughes will take it off behind his net. Throw it to Boudreau. Boudreau just throws it into the center of the ice and Stewart picks it off. good block shot there by, I believe that was Hughes once again. Yes, it was. Shot out in front, and it's in. Murphy will grab the rebound as it just bounced through the pads of Hugh McInnes, and he will pot it to make it 4-2. So Murphy with his first of the game, making it 4-2 for the Mariners. Run out in front. We've seen that a couple times already tonight. Throwing out in front just bounces around, and somebody's able to find that loose puck and throw it in the goal. Aker and Cameron, but Aker will win that one. Back to the defense. We'll dump it in, however, not quite over the blue line, over the red line, however. And we'll come all the way down to Boudreaux's right on the defensive end. Grab the puck at the blue line and skate out with it. 2-on-2 right now. Wallace going to the net. Aker will in behind the goal. Off to the right, throw it out in front of the net. It's quickly covered by Key McInnes. To his right with the pad. Aker trying to throw that in front for Wallace. Waiting there, stick down, hoping to pot a quick one-timer. But snuffed by Key McInnes. Aker on the draw once again. Meyer for the Bulldogs will take this one. Meyer will get kicked out of the faceoff dot, and Warcott will come in. Aker will win another draw in a row. That's at least three in a row that he's won now, just in this one shift alone. McDonald will clear it up the boards, trying to get it to Meyer. So stopped by Nickerson, who will throw it in on goal. Blocked shot there by the Bulldogs defender, who will clear it out. That, if it's going wide, will be, that will just be on goal, so we'll have no icing on that one. The potty will move it around the boards there to Wallace. Wallace waiting along the boards, skips by her, and Aker battling for the puck along with Wallace with three Bulldog forwards, and Aker comes away with it, moves it ahead to Nickerson. Got oil draped all over him, it just keeps bowling forward. Still on it. We've got a penalty coming up here to the Bulldogs on one of the two Boyles with the hook. There's body contact by one Boyle and a hook by the other Boyle. So I wasn't 100% sure which one they're calling. They have Meyer going to the box. Okay. So I will put that one on the calendar. I was wrong. It was neither Boyle. It was Meyer with the penalty. I thought Meyer was on the other end of the ice, but it will be Grayson Myers going to serve that penalty as the Mariners will go to the power play. He throws it to the corner. Murphy on it now is our most recent goal scorer. Tries to throw it in front of the net. It's blocked by Cameron. Mariners at the point try to just throw it in on goal. It's snuffed there by Bulldogs defenders, and it's clear down the length of the ice. The Yarmouth Mariners will head into the second intermission, up 4-2. Goal scored in this one by, started by Wallace, as she was able to pot a pass out in front that Kington Lewis threw on the power play. As we ended the first period 1-0, Kingston Lewis then scored his goal once again on the power play as he was able to put it high over the blocker side of Key McInnes. Boudreaux then cutting the lead, making it 2-1 for the Mariners. After the pass out in front by Hopkins, and Boudreaux was able to get one by at 14-12 of the second period to cut the lead to 2-1. And Jas Stewart on a pass out in front by Will Murphy was able to increase the Mariners' lead back to 3-2. Off Hopkins, however, quickly responded on a power play goal of their own after the puck thrown on net by Boudreau got blocked by several players on the way to the net, but Hopkins is able to find the puck to the left of Boudreau of the Mariners and was able to make it 3-2 at that point, And then finally, with just a minute 29 left in the second period, Will Murphy, after the puck was thrown out in front of the net by Jazz Stewart, puck just kept bouncing, and eventually Will Murphy was able to pot it to the left of Key McInnes. So we'll step aside here for the intermission as they clear the ice and we get ready for the third period at the Rathieson Community Center. The Yarmouth Mariners lead the Bulldogs 4-2. Welcome back to the Rasmussen and Community Center, where we've got the Yarmouth Mariners and Antigonish Bulldogs in the U11-A level league final provincial championship. Yarmouth Mariners are holding a full 4-2 lead. Goals by Wallace, Lucas, Stewart, and Murphy for the Mariners, whereas Boudreaux and Hopkins have the goals for the Bulldogs. The clock to wind down here as we'll get this third period on the way. See who we've got as provincial champions. The U11-B championship. 9 o'clock this morning. That was won by the Cole Harbour Wings as they clashed with the game, assisted on the first one for the Mariners, that is. And for the Bulldogs, I'll eventually see a jersey number. You know that is Nick Hattie on the draw there for the Bulldogs. Lucas will take the draw for the Mariners. Going to jump on that one, want to get the draw win, and he will win another one. And Boudreaux on the puck for the Bulldogs, however, he'll jump that draw and move in. Quick shot, but just wide of the net. Thrown out in front there by Boudreaux. McHattie on it now. Bounces just wide of the net. Murphy on it for the Mariners. They'll move it ahead there. McKenzie on the puck. Being pursued by McHattie. McKenzie picks off the clearing attempt. Throws it in on goal. Just wide of the net. Lucas will throw it back to the net. On the puck now. He'll move it to Murphy. Murphy throws it in on goal. Just wide. McHattie on it now. Just off the side of the net. Murphy at the point and grab the puck. He'll get tripped up, a no call there right in front of the referee, so more so lost an edge than getting a stick in the feet, I guess. And McIntyre will move it ahead. McHattie will take it from him. Throw it in wide of the net. Murphy will grab it for the Mariners and move it up. Dion in pursuit, but kept in at the line by the Bulldogs defender. Thrown right back down to Murphy. And Dion attempting to get it out still, but unsuccessful. McIntyre on it now, and once again back to Dion. He'll take a third time, so Charm getting it out, and he will. Gets it over to Lucas. Lucas in over the red line, over the blue line. He's got McKenzie and Dion with him, but he'll take the shot. Good save there by Key McInnes. And it's cleared out past the Mariners defender, and Murphy. Referee's going to say he could have got to that if he was hustling. It's been a long shift. He did start this period, and we're already, a minute and a half into this period. 13:15 left in the third period there. The Mariners up 4-2. Scrambling from the net, and the Bulldogs come away with it. A bullet off the puck. Wallace taking the puck from Hopkins. Lewis on goal. Good save there by Key McInnes. And Hopkins will try to clear it out, but Huckleson will keep it in. Thrown in on goal, blocked there by number 8 of the Bulldogs. And we'll move it out. Bulldogs chip it ahead there, and Boyle is upended. Sorry, Myers is upended there, and we've got a couple bodies down. Everybody looks to be okay there. Penalty for number 35 of the Mariners. That is Soracles. Apologies for my pronunciation. I'm not 100% sure on this pronunciation, but Akers will take the draw for the Mariners to start this penalty kill. Looks like Cameron for the Bulldogs taking the draw against him. And kind of a stalemate there as a poor drop of the puck by the officials. Just kind of bounces off to the side. And Akers throws it out. Hickelson throws it out past Hughes. And we'll reset here on the power play as Hopkins will move it over to McIntyre. Skips it ahead to Cameron. Cameron throws it off Akers and chips ahead. Wartop on the puck now, but throws it to the corner there. Boyle in pursuit. for the Bulldogs. Wallace will take the puck up the left wing and just dump it down the length of the ice there. Hughes going back for that one. Wallace in pursuit. A little bit of pressure. And that pressure almost pays off. It almost gets turned over there to Baker in front of the net. Boyle on the puck for the Bulldogs. Move it ahead for Cameron. Cameron down the right wing. Does have Boudreau on the center of the ice, but he'll throw down goals. Skips off Boudreau, Mariners goaltender, but cleared to the corner nicely by the Mariners defenseman. Hughes, great job by Hughes just to at least stop the scoring chance, but out comes Stewart for the Mariners. He'll throw it in the goal just wide of the net. So the Bulldogs will pick that one up and work their way out. 4-on-2 at the moment. Hopkins on the puck. He'll throw it on goal. Nice save by Boudreau. Loose puck. Still loose. Referee has blown that one down before Hopkins was able to find the loose puck. It was under Boudreau for a little while. It skipped out to his left, and Hopkins found the puck. But the referee had already blown it dead. Good call to the referee as that was under Boudreau for a little while. Just long enough for the whistle to have been blown. And we will stay 4-2 for the Mariners. Credit Union Community Center and the Rathies and Community Center. I love trying to say that as fast as possible because it is a tongue twister. That's why we shrink the name down to just the wreck. McHatty, saved by Boudreau. Just getting the tip of his skate on that shot. Hopkins in a little bit of pain after he took that shot and collapsed in the hash marks. Seems to be a little bit of pain as he went to the bench, but hopefully nothing too serious for Hughes on that play. Keep an eye for if he's back on the ice. Shot on goal there by McHatty and a nice save by Boudreau, and is cleared by the Mariners defenders. Right on Key McInnes will just clear it to the corner, and Cameron in the corner for it. 3 seconds left on the power play here. We're back to even strength after fighting with the door for a second. Mariners defender unable to get back on the ice. That was a good 4 or 5 seconds extra stuck in the penalty box. She couldn't get the door open. I mean, the timekeeper came over and gave her a hand with it. Murphy on the puck there. For the Mariners moves ahead for Lucas. Team captain coming in. We've got McKenzie with him. Throws the shot on goal just wide of the net. I don't know if Key McInnes may have got a blocker on that or not. Murphy with a move along the boards. Turns it over. Boyle will dump it down the length of the ice. That should be icing, and it will be. Just a little too much on that as he tried to chip it along the boards to himself. But just a little bit too much oomph on that one. Looks like Cameron will take this draw against Lucas. Lucas, the Mariners captain, has a goal and an assist on the first two of the game, the first two power play goals of this game. A quick one in on goal. Steered aside by Key McInnes. Bulldogs throw it through the center of the ice to their right winger. He'll chip it in deep after getting the red line. And Huckleson, on pursuit there. Cameron throws it in for the net, but it's blocked there by Lewis. Good job by the young forward moving it up. Captain leading by example on that one. Dion tries to get it ahead to Lewis, but just couldn't quite get a handle on that puck with two Bulldogs around him. Back to Huckleson. Thrown in on goal, but unable to get a stick on it was Lewis. Two Bulldogs draped around him, able to clear that one aside. Bulldogs in as Cameron tries to work his way around a couple defenders, but has cleared out. Lacan dumps it in deep. McIntyre on it now. Dion and Lewis both on him, and Dion's able to take the puck away, throws it in front for Lewis, but unable to get a shot off. Takes a shot now just over the net. Key McInnes may have got a shoulder on that to steer it up over top, or it may have just been fired just above the crossbar. But great job by Lewis to locate that puck in the hash marks and get that shot off. Boyle on the puck, unable to get to that one in the center. Lucas will challenge along the boards there, and he'll not now go for the line change. Wallace along the boards will block the clearing attempt. It's not quite kept in, however, by Vakon. Wallace will check up at the blue line and go back in at pursuit. Cleared again by the Bulldogs to center ice. As Boyle's on the puck now. Makes a move around one defender. And it's a goal. Up to the right, just thrown in on goal. And just squeaks through. That is Warkop with the goal. As I was looking down trying to figure out which Boyle that was Brody Boyle who got in over the line and threw it in on goal. The rebound came out to the right. And Blake Warkop cuts this lead to 4-3. Myers, McCaddy, and I don't remember their extra winger who plays on this line. Will come out and Aker will win the draw against McCaddy. Boudreau is their left winger on this line. Boyle behind the net. That is Jonathan Boyle. Nickerson along the boards. I would just skip by him. Knocks down his assignment. Myers on the puck now. He gets tripped up. No call on the play. Mariner is finally able to clear it out. McDonald on it now. Tries to move it over to Boyle, but is unable to get it there. Wallace on the puck now. Battles through Boyle, no problem. Throws in on goal. Good stick check there by McInnes to clear that one aside on the nice poke check. Just skips out the center there. Wallace has to let that one go by her as she works her way back onside. McDonald in over the red line. We'll move it over there to Boudreau. Boudreau does have one goal already in this one, but his shot gets blocked nicely by number 6. That was Potty on the block shot. Boyle moves ahead to Aker, picks it up again. Akers definitely has the size advantage on just about everybody on the ice by looks of it. Probably a good 2 or 3 inches taller than just about everybody on the Bulldogs. So use that long stick, he's able to intercept a lot of passes and he's able to get a good stick check. We've seen that a few times already tonight. So the puck just skips by Nickerson. McIntyre on in pursuit for the Bulldogs into the corner. He'll just chip it by Nickerson and Myers will pick it up at the blue line. Oh, he's got Murphy on him. A good poke check there by Murphy will knock the puck away and he'll move forward with it. Use this gate to stick and throw it in on goal. Good glove save by Key McInnes, but he'll drop it by mistake. Skips by Potty at the blue line. Mariners will move it back up. McKenzie at the center. Gets it by McKenzie and McIntyre battling for it. McKenzie of the Mariners tries to come away with it, but Cameron is able to back check and come take that one away, but it's back to McKenzie. McKenzie coming in. He's got Stewart with him. He'll take the shot just off the post. A scoring opportunity there by McKenzie, but the post comes up big. And goalie will say he knows the size of his net, 4x6. He knew that 6 was there. He let that puck go by off the post. He knew what he was doing. Thrown in on goal, and Boudreau will just cover this one up for the Mariners. A scoring opportunity there by McKenzie. He's able to beat Key McInnes, but can't beat the post. It's the second or third post we've had in this game. As the Mariners have just been ripping shots, but McCaddy and Lewis on the draw there. And bit of a tie-up as it just goes off to the side. Mariners are able to clear it out, however. Cameron on it now, just keep trying to shovel it forward, but the Mariners able to pick it up, and Dion, in with four players around him, he's able still just get the shot off. It's covered up by Key McInnes. Great job by the young netminder to grab that puck. Still get taps by Boudreau, Warkop. I believe that was McDaniels, the third player in there, just thanking their goaltender for keeping this game 4-2. Lucas wins the draw to Dion, but he loses the puck. It's McCaddy, quick on the pressure. Huckelson clears it in. Boudreau on the puck now. He's got McCaddy who's right, and he'll throw it there, who tries to cut it through back to Boudreau. who will now head off on the hooking call as he takes down Dion in the neutral zone, just trying to battle for the puck, and just the stick got caught up a little bit too much. And the Mariners will get, I believe this will be their third power play. They scored on the previous two. Check the box score here and make sure I'm not, at least this isn't the reason I'm crazy. No, this will be their fourth power play. So the Mariners will try to go two for four on the power play. Bulldogs will try to keep this one right where we're at it, 4-3. If not, score shorthanded goal themselves to tie this game up if they could. Huckelson's not able to keep it in. It just skips by him at the blue line. Clears it right back in. Boyle has it jumped by him and McDonald on it now behind the net. Try to chip it out, but Dion blocks that. He's got Murphy in front of the net. Tries to throw it there. Lucas on it now. Lucas throw the black backhand in, but not quite able to. Huskelson steps in from the point, but is unable to keep it in. Boyle out with it now, but Dion meets him at the front of his team's bench and is able to block that. Apologies, my HDMI cable came out here again. Try to get the video back here in a second. Come on, you little bugger. There we go. Apologies on that. McIntyre just stops a chance in front of his own net as that trickled in just wide of the goal. Murphy on it now. Throws it back to the point. Block shot there. Great block shot. That was McInnes, I believe, of the Bulldogs on that block shot. Throw it up the boards. Hughes is able to keep it in there as we've got 35 seconds left on the penalty kill for the Bulldogs. Hughes will be unable to keep that one in as Lewis is on it quick. He's got Wallace with him. This is how they scored the first goal of the game. Unable to get the pass through. A great block shot, but it does get through this time. Wallace trying to get the shot off. A couple block shots and a nice save there by Key. McInnes in front of the net. Chance there as the Mariners bounces back to the point. It is able to be kept in there. Oh, great shot there. Chance by number 20, McKenzie, but unable to get that one on goal. Penalty is over. We're back to 5-on-5 hockey here. Mariners still holding the 4-3 lead. We've got McKenzie coming in now. Good stick check there by the defender for the Bulldogs. Able to poke that puck away. And it's cleared out the center. It'll just get chipped back in. Cleared right back to center again. 2-on-1 now. It's shaping up. Just unable to get that pass through. Cameron tried to feed it through for the big breakaway, but couldn't quite get it. Myers in now, just offside. Cameron couldn't quite get his foot back in. Tried to get back onside in time, but just the timing off by just a split second. Half a stride away from getting back onside on that play. Lewis and Myers will take the draw. Bulldog stick down to the left of Key McInnes. Sticks cleaned up off the ice and off to the bench. Lewis and Myers. Myers able to win that puck forward and dumped in by Cameron, this time onside. Moved out. McDonald will get to this one before it's icing. Tries to move it up the boards, but it's blocked there by Murphy, and Lucas will be the first one to it for the Mariners. It'll turn back away from Boyle. Throws it out in front. Dion, what a save by Key McInnes. Beautiful save by the young netminder. Stacking the pads on that one just to get the toe on it. Murphy on it now behind the net for the Mariners. Throws it back to the point. Shot coming in high. Nice save by Key McInnes. The young netminder has been on top of his game in net this game. He has done everything he can for this Bulldogs team to try to keep them in this championship game. The U11-A level Yarmouth Mariners and the Finnish Bulldogs. Mariners lead 4-3 with a minute 43 left in this period. Shots on goal so far in this game. The Mariners lead 24-13. Bulldogs just unable to get much set up in the Mariners' end. They've been great in their defensive zone and really good at holding the line, both the blue and the red line, to force a couple icings on the Bulldogs as well, as they've been hemmed in their own end quite often. Murphy tries to dump it in. McIntyre is able to block that. It's chipped ahead. McCaddy on it now. He'll dump it in. Attempted to be cleared back out, but it hit McCaddy at the hash marks. It is cleared out this time to McIntyre and dumped back up the ice. Lucas out there now. He'll clear it, circle back around and bring it back in the zone. He'll make one move around the defender. He's all in on his own. He'll throw it in on goal and just kicked aside by Key McInnes. We're into the last minute of play in this third period here. Can the Bulldogs tie it? Will the Mariners hold on to win this provincial championship? Only 40 seconds to find out. Wallace will grab the puck there in the center for the Mariners. Just trying to kill off some time. Throw it in on goal. Good blocker saved by Key McInnes. That was the label top corner. Akers with a one-timer. Just trickles over the pad. What a shot. What a goal. As Key McInnes isn't quite able to get the pad in place to make that save. Akers with the one-timer. A little snapshot from the hash marks. And he's able to pop that one through. Good play all around for the Mariners as Wallace was able to keep the puck, or get the puck back in from the blue line. Timeout by the Bulldogs here as they'll try to draw something up. 25.5 seconds left. That .5 might be a difference. You never know in games like this. 26-13, but ultimately the numbers that really matter. Mariners 5, Bulldogs 3. 26-13 shots. Key McInnes has been lights out in net. He's taken some bouncing pucks to get it by him. He's been squared with Lodges. Quick pass, quick feet. On the other end, Bujo. 3 goals on 13 shots. He's been very sharp when he's tired of these kind of games. So much happening in front of you at the other end of the ice. Trying to get himself focused. I can just imagine, based on the videos I've seen online, he's having full-on conversations with himself down there. We know how crazy goalies are, right? But he's keeping himself engaged. He's doing really well for his team to hold them in it. Keeping this only 5-3 for the Mariners as they'll try to hold on here. We're under 20 seconds. Boudreaux bringing it in for the Bulldogs. Boudreaux trying to cut in towards the net. Unable to get by. Bulldogs have pulled their goalie. This is 6-on-5, but Fakan will clear it out. 5 seconds left. You can start the countdown now if you want for the parents. As McIntyre doesn't have a stick, so he's not really able to move it up that quickly. Boudreaux. U11-A division provincial champions, and they create a dog pile on top of their netminder. Yarmouth Mariners, led by captain Kingston Lewis, goal and assist. Assistant captain Will Murphy also with a goal and assist in the game. The fourth goal, which will hold up as the game-winning goal for that matter. 5-3, Yarmouth Mariners. They will win the U11-A division provincial championship. Get handshakes between the two teams here before we... handshakes at the end of a game. Do it at all levels when it comes to games like this. It's always great to see that respect among hockey players. Players in the game after this one, and then awards medals, silver medals to the Antigonish Bulldogs, gold medals and championship banner for provincial champions to the Yarmouth Mariners. We'll turn things over to the PA announcer and step aside.
The players of the game for the silver medalists and Antigonish Bulldogs.
Okay, McInnes gets the player of the game for the Bulldogs. What a performance inside the cage for that netminder. And Will Murphy with the game-winning goal. He'll get the player of the game for the Mariners. Great performance. Could have gone to just about any player on this team. They all had an amazing show. Will Murphy will be your player of the game for the Mariners. I'll step aside for this one. From the Rathason Community Center, Duncan McLean. Yarmouth Mariners 5, Bulldogs 3. The league championship game. Yarmouth Mariners win the U11-A Division Provincial Championship.
Number 12, John.